This is the presentation of Group 9 addressing the importance of the psychological contract and the impact of SHRM on the baby. Today we will define the contract, explain why it's important, define SHRM, and finally explain the impact of SHRM. The psychological contract was first introduced by Chris Agris in 1960. It aims to explain the relationship of employment that occurs separate to a formal, codified contract of employment. There are multiple key factors. These include an unwritten set of rules, a set of mutual beliefs.
Psychological contract are undeclared assumptions held by members of an organisation. It's the perceptions of two parties, the employer and employee, and what their mutual obligations are towards each other. The psychological contract is key to the morale of our employees. By developing for the future and using strategy as a means of creating a positive environment for our employees, their contracts can be fulfilled and they will integrate better into the organisation. There are two aspects to the psychological contract, relational and transactional. It differs from a formal contract of employment as it is not necessarily written down. The contracts are rarely acknowledged explicitly, but are understood by both employees and employers. Managers must remember that employment relationships may deteriorate despite management's best efforts. However, it is their duty as managers to maintain these relationships. Psychological contract provides a framework for monitoring employees' attitudes and approaches that influence the performance of the organisation. The distinctive feature of HRM is its assumption that improved performance is achieved through the people in the organisation. These practices send a strong message about what organisations expect and what employees can anticipate in return, therefore determining the state of the psychological contract. Harrison defines employee development as the skillful provision and organisation of learning experiences in the workplace. T&D is therefore done so that performance can be improved, work goals can be achieved, and that through enhancing the skills, knowledge, learning ability, and enthusiasm at every level, there can be continuous organisational as well as individual growth. During recruitment, interviews, and orientation, HRM personnel should clearly and honestly communicate the responsibilities and expectations of the employee, as well as those the organisation will give in exchange.
Appraisal is the judgment of an employee's performance in the job, based on considerations other than productivity alone. Performance reviews are important as they offer an opportunity for the employee to receive accurate feedback on their performance and may help dispel any false beliefs. Rewards are compensation, and effort in an equitable and just manner. An organisation must reward short-term as well as long-term achievements, bearing in mind that business must perform in the present to succeed in the future. People are a key resource in business. Aligning them towards your overall objectives is very important to the company's success. This is why managing the needs and desires of these people, including their expectations in the psychological contract, has a direct effect on the success of the firm. SHRM aims to create goals that are attainable and workable for staff. It's all about achieving your goals through the performance of your people. HR management is the way in which you manage people in an organization through recruitment, training, and evaluation. SHRM integrates the organization's strategy with the management of its people. It defines how goals will be achieved through good HR practices. If they have expectations we fail to uphold, then a strategy hasn't aligned with HR needs. Google embraces the need for both man management and a focus on strategic goals. Driving your workforce towards objectives is a key factor to success. It's not just about physical resources or capabilities. People are more important, and the psychological contract plays a huge role in performance. Google's recruitment and management is covered by teams with HR, strategic, and financial backgrounds. A key HR factor is to keep employees working at their best. Happy and fulfilled employees can drive your business forward. An unhappy employee will never reach their potential. In conclusion, the psychological contract is a key to this happiness. By aligning management with HR, this enables any recruitment or performance requirements to be met to prevent unnecessary strain on them.